I got thinking about baseball and how games are marketed today. You know, you go to a game manufacturer and they figure everything out and decide whether the game is right for the public or not, and then they market it. And it got me to thinking, supposing Abner Doubleday had called one of the game manufacturers with this new invention of his called baseball. Now, I think a phone conversation would have taken place something like this. Hello, Olympic Games. What can I do for you, Mr. Doubleday? You've got a game. How many couples? 18 people? That's a lot of people. Well, the ideal game is, two, three couples, you know, come over to the house, they get a little smashed, and, you know. You can't play it in the house either. See, you got two things right there against you. See? All right, tell me about it. All right, you got nine guys on each side. Yeah. And you got a pitcher and a catcher. And they throw this ball back and forth. And that's all there is to it? All right. A guy from the other side stands between them with a bat. I see. And he just watches him. Oh, I see. He swings at it. He may or he may not swing at it. Depending on what? If it looked like it were a ball. What's a ball, Mr. Doubleday? You've got this plate. Uh-huh. And as long as it's above the knees, but below the shoulders. Yeah. No, go ahead. I'm listening. Yeah. It's a strike. Three strikes and you're out. And three balls. Not three balls. Four balls. Why four balls, Mr. Double? Nobody's ever asked you before. Or he may hit it. If he hits it, what happens? He runs as far as he can before somebody catches it. As long as it stays what? As long as it stays fair. And what's fair, Mr. Doubleday? You've got these two white lines? Is this a rib? Is this one of the guys in the office? Who is it? Mr. Doubleday, that's the most complicated game I've ever heard in my life. Forget it. Right. Mr. Doubleday, listen, though. You come up with anything, two, three couples, you'll be sure and let us know, huh? All right, Mr. Doubleday, I'll be talking. Bye.